Hello everyone, Namaskar, Raj Krishna this side. Let's solve this question. It says solve x sin x plus cos x equals to 0 by Newton-Raphson method, correct to 4 decimal places. So what is the function which they have given? In Newton-Raphson method, function is important. So function is x sin x plus cos x equals to 0. Now, its derivative is also important, so let's do that. X sin x will use the product rule. X as it is, derivative of sin x is cos x, plus sin x as it is, derivative of x is 1, and derivative of cos x is minus sin x. So your f dash x is simplified to x cos x simply. Okay, now we have to choose in which interval our root lies. So for that, let's check the value of function at 0. So obviously at 0 it will be cos 0, which is 1. Value of function at 1 I have to check next. So it will be 1 times. Make sure you make your calculator to radians for this problem. You have some option. So convert it from degree to radian. So f of 1, that means I have sine of 1 plus cos of 1. So this is giving me 1.381. Again, it is positive only. Okay, so 1.381773. What about f of 2? If I see at f of 2, so that will be two sine two. 2 times sine 2 plus cos 2. So this is again 1.4, then next 3 times sine 3 plus cos 3. Okay, 3 times sine 3 plus cos 3. So this is coming out to be negative. Okay, so f of 2 I have to write again, but let's first write f of 3, which is minus 0.566632. And what about f of 2? That will be 2 times sine 2 plus cos 2, and that came out to be 1.402448. So obviously our root lies between 2 and 3. So can we get a bit more closer to the root if possible, so that we can reduce the number of iteration. So if we check the value at 2.5, so what will be that? 2.5 sine 2.5 plus cos 2.5. And that is coming out to be equal to, again, positive. So I can say f of 2.5 is coming out to be 0.695037. Okay. So this is the interval in which your root lies. That interval is 2.5 and 3. This is your interval. Now, out of this interval, at which value of x the root is closer to 0? You will say at 3 it is closer to 0 because it is 0.56 there on negative side, and it is 0.6 at 2.5. So the x naught will choose here will obviously be 3 because at 3 it is closer to 0. So your x naught is 3. So when you got the value of x naught, you can start off with your iteration. So for your first iteration, iteration number 1, you will write x1 will be x naught minus value of function at 3. So value of function at 3, it is minus 0.56632. So minus minus plus 0.56632. And what is the derivative at 3? So that is, a derivative is x cos x simply. So 3 cos 3. 3 cos 3. And that is coming out to be equal to minus of 2.969977. Okay. So let's calculate the overall value of x1. So that is 3 minus, and then I have 0.56632 and 2.969977. So this is what we are having, and this has come out to be, the value of x1 is 2.809213. This is your value of x1. Now let's move to iteration number 2, and obviously this x1 will be used there. So iteration number 2, so that will be x2 equals to x1, which is 2.809213 minus value of function at this point. Okay, so your function is x, so 2.809213 into sine 2.809213 plus cos 2.809213. Okay, so this is coming out to be minus of something, so it will become plus 0.028641 divided by, now value of x cos x at this point, so that will be 2.809213 cos of 2.809213. So again, that is negative of 2.655461. So the overall value of x2 will be 2.809213 minus, then I have 0.028641 divided by 2.655461, and this is coming out to be equal to 2.798427. If I compare it to the previous one, which was 2.80, we haven't even come across a single digit of matching, so we'll have to work harder. Now iteration number 3, let's do it a bit faster. So x3 will be 2.798427 minus value of function, so 2.798 427 into sine of 2.798427 and plus cos of 2.798427, and this is coming out to be negative of, so plus 2.798427 cos of 2.798427. So this value is coming again negative of 2.635263. Let's calculate the overall value, which is 2.798427 minus of 0.000108 divided by 2.635263 2.798386. So we have got it closer now, up to 3 decimal places. We have to work hard for one more decimal places to be match. So let's move up to iteration number 4. I think this would be enough. Let's see iteration number 4. X4 2.798386 this time minus. So this is 2.798386, okay, into sine of 2.798386 plus cos of 2.798386. So this is a beautiful number. This is 0.6 times 0, because I have set the number of decimal places in my calculator to 6, and below I have cos of 2.798386. This is coming negative of 2.635185. So at this point of time, I think I have to make fix my decimal place to 8 decimal places, let's say, and then I have to calculate, because this will always give me 0. Okay, so I have to move some decimal places more and now calculate the value of this. So this is 2.798386 sine of 2.798386 plus cos of 2.798386. Yes, now it is coming a bit better. 0. Now 6 times 0 was already there, and then followed by 1 2 divided by 2.798386 and x cos x was there, I think. Yes, cos of 2.798386. This is coming minus 2.635185537. Now this minus minus will, what is the overall value? That is, plus 0.12 1 2 3 4 5 6 1 2 divided by 2.635185537, and this is now coming out to be equal to 2.798 and 38605. Perfect. I have got this equal to a lot more decimal places this time. So this is what I was looking for. They asked up to 4 decimal places. That means I have to give up till 2.7983 as my final answer. So x equal to 2.7983. correct up to 4 decimal places. So that's it for this problem. We did a lot of hard work for this, not much, only till 4 iteration, but yes. So sometimes it comes 0000 up to. So then if you will divide, that will not work because that will ultimately come out to be equal to 0. So you have to fix your decimal places or write some more digits, okay, so that it gives some positive quantity, okay. So that's it for today. You can see more such problem on the playlist Iterative Techniques and Interpolation. Thanks.